Hello and welcome to an all new Iron Tries. First off, how are you digging my new great background? I think my new furniture is awesome. Second, not only it's my 10th episode, but also when I'm uploading this, it will be my birthday. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, when I'm uploading this, it will be the 27th annual International Ardawen Day. Yeah. So, as my 10th episode, I'm going to do it a little special. Not too special though, because, well, it's only the 10th episode and not like the 50th or something. But still, 10th episode, a little bit of a milestone, also my birthday. So, you know what? Let's do it a little bit special. So, yeah, this is a little bit awkward. So, as some of your Facebook followers saw, I did order some stuff on the internet for my 10th episode. But it didn't arrive yet. And since it's now Thursday and my birthday is Saturday, I couldn't wait any longer. So I went to our local Asian supermarket and I found some things that that might be interesting. So let's see what I've got here. For starters, I bought this crispy seaweed. I was a little bit, as you might understand, I was a little bit hesitant to buy this because it's fucking seaweed. But I figured that it might be fun for you guys to see me try this. So, you know what? I did it. Yeah. Of course, I'm not going to do it without the help of my special friend, Mr. Bucket. What can I do without my special friend, Mr. Bucket? So yeah, you know, and seaweed is supposed to be the future food that's going to save us all from extinction. So yeah, I'm really curious. It's supposed to be good tasting and healthy. I believe the healthy, but I'm kind of afraid from the good taste. Well, on the back side, it's too small to read. It says that you're supposed to drink it with your favorite drink. You know, and to show you what kind of drink I picked out, I have to tell you a little story. Back in the 90s, when I was still a little Ardawen, there was this drink that was being sold here called punica. And it was a glorious drink, and everybody loved it, and everybody drank it, and we were all happy with it. It was actually one of the first fruit drinks. I'm not talking about fruit juices, I'm talking about fruit drinks. It was being sold. It was from German origin and it was sold in those really noticeable glass bottles. And when you opened them, they gave a special sound. And there were cheesy commercial about it, but we didn't care. We loved it. I was even a member of the Punica Club. And yeah, it was the most awesome drink of my time, and then it vanished. Yeah, not everywhere. I mean, it was supposedly still sold in Germany, even though I never went to Germany to actually try it out. But now, and I was I wasn't really told about it. It's back all of a sudden. I mean, right after the Mountain Dew episode, I was thinking, and I thought, you know what? I really miss punica. Let's see if I can get it somewhere. And I found out that it was supposedly sold like in the Netherlands, even in supermarket branches that I have in my neighborhood, but I could not find it. And then I walked into the Asian supermarket today, and yes, it's in plastic bottles, unfortunately, but here we are, 1, 2, and I couldn't be more happy. So yeah, my favorite drink today, it's going to be this. I'm so happy that I found this. I have to tell you guys, I because I love you guys so much, I waited until I was shooting this episode before I tasted it. But I wanted to try it out straight when I got home. I am so happy to found this, and I'm definitely going to buy more if it tastes good. So yeah, because this drink was so epic that one of my favorite punk bands made a song about how epic this drink was, and not for marketing reasons. That wasn't a commercial or anything. They genuinely made it because this drink was so awesome, and it fucking is. You know what? This might be the drink that, for me, puts Mountain Dew to shame. So, before I go into taste me some seaweed, let's pour this. While I'm opening this bottle and pouring it in, when you're wondering, yes, I also got Japanese candy through the mail, but that will be for the next episode, which possibly be aired on the same day. I'm thinking of making it a double episode as a sort of gift to you from me as my birthday gift to you. But I'm not sure yet. So no promises, but you will see the new envelope thing soon. Let's just say that soon. So first, the colors of punica are as they are, and it actually smells. It smells just like I remember it. I only really miss the sound of opening the bottles, but you can't have it all. So dear friend Mr. Bucket, I'm sorry if I'm going to do this to you. So, the looks of it makes me almost even more scary than the last episode, you know, with the slimy thing. It looks like a piece of cardboard. It is crispy though, and it probably, you heard the sound when I was breaking it. Delicious with good nutrition from the sea. Well, you know, it is pretty bad, but it's not as bad as I figured it would be. But yeah, it's still pretty bad. Oh well. Maybe some of my friends likes it when they are on my birthday. So now it's time for the epicness of epicness. First off, the multivitamin punica. Oh, the smell. This is so awesome. I'm so fucking happy. Oh, yeah. Getting an orgasm here. Sorry, guys. Yeah. You know, this brings back memories. So, the other one, orange. Orange with apple, I guess. It's in German. My German isn't that good. Also good. Not as good as the multivitamin, but hell, I'm... Yeah. Yeah, I'm really happy that I bought this. I'm definitely going to buy more in the future. I now know where to get it. I'm so happy. Well, punica, man, punica. You know what? It does bring Mountain Dew to shame. Fuck Mountain Dew. Punica, man. Punica. Well, finally, remember my very first episode? It was beer with green tea. This is lemon candy with green tea. So, well, you know what? I thought it was fitting, so I brought it along as well. Just a little gimmick at the end. I don't expect it to be too much. Oh god, I'm such a well. It does look a bit, you know, you see it, like there's something inside. It's special, I guess. Oh, the inside is lemon, and the outside is green tea. Yeah, the outside is definitely green tea. No, actually quite good. So yeah, this was a little joke at the end. So this was my birthday episode, really quickly. To all you Dutch people out there, I wish you a really great April 30th, Queen's Day, and of course May 5th, really awesome May 5th. I'll be in Wageningen celebrating May 5th somewhere at near the Kabau am Gamal stage. Maybe I see you there. When you're there, just say hi and we drink and drink together and celebrate our freedom. And if not, well,
I'll see you on an audio.
Ardawen tries.
Until next time, guys. Bye.